Super Bowl 57. And this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Dolphins and the Giants coming up next.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Miami Dolphins taking on the NFC champions, the New York Giants.
Brandon Gunn, along with Charles Davis, and what a season it's been for our AFC champions. And this was a fight just to get to the Super Bowl. You got to figure that they are very battle-tested and ready.
I'd agree with you 100% about that. You don't get there without having those types of attributes, and that's what you look for in a Super Bowl team. Character, confidence, these guys don't lack for either one of those. Now they're here. Now they're ready to win.
Meanwhile, our NFC champions, they have gone through a lot to get where they are. Everybody knows their story this season. What's the key for them as they start this Super Bowl?
Let's go full cliche on this one because it works. Remember what got you here. Been a winning formula all season long. This is a team that when we saw them in the preseason, we said they look like a group that has what it takes to be a Super Bowl winning team. And we've been proven right by what we've seen throughout the season.
Now Tua. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Play action, now it's Tua. He gets this complete to Shaheen, the tight end. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. A gain of six there on first.
A 6-yard pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. And again, it's Tagovailoa. This one swung out here to Jones. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, just keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. The 30. 10.
Hey, ready for it.
And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Giants touchdown. Graham Gano on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Giants have a 7-0 lead. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Throw left side here, complete to the tight end, Gesicki. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up.
Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And a return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball in. run to the hole in the zone, but those windows can open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
Jones fakes the give to Barkley. They'll roll him out right. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handle winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things, and then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Throwing Jones. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way he wanted to start this ball game as it brings up fourth down. On fourth down, on is Graham Gano for the Giants' field goal. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. And Gano's kick is right through. And that will make it 10-0 here in the first. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. This one complete to Jalen Waddle. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
Meanwhile, to his throw here, taken in by Gesicki.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Tua sets up to pass it. This will be caught. It's Waddle. It's on the way in for a Miami touchdown. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and the lead is down to a field goal. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away. Sanders. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. Picked up by Javon Holland. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. What a moment for him. A pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that one pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison of the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended. That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown, 75 yards.
You recall him on. What a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And it'll make it a second down. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
So a solid run by Saquon Barkley and another first and 10 here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there. Second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Now Jones, sliding out of the pocket. Open receiver, that's Caden Smith, the tight end. And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line. It's a big-time play there for the G-men.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
A first down carry for Barkley. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. And Ingram's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Evan Ingram. There to make the grab. And the Giants are going to jump back in front. And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point try, good by Gano. And it's now 17-14. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 47. Out of the pistol, the give to Jones. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. He's already put it on the ground once in this first half. There no gain, just struggling to get going.
Yeah, and what he needs right now, a dose of confidence, which means his guys have to chop a hole, a big one for him, give him a chance to run a little bit, and gain some of that confidence back. He didn't get it on that carry. going.
And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
To throw once more on second and 10. Tua drops it to Jones in the flat. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Looking to complete it to Pettis, and he's got him. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
Second and goal. Tua under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line. Dexter Lawrence able to get him for a loss of about 3. Third and goal, a big play in this Super Bowl. Looking to pass. Tua. And he's got his tight end Gesicki in the end zone. Touchdown, Dolphins. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Dolphins are once again going to retake the lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that will make this a 4-point game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And that's complete to Trey McKitty, the tight end. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. They'll run on first down. Barkley. And he's not even able to get back to the line of scrimmage. And there's also a flag down, and it's in the area of holding. They'll come up now. to throw. Jones eluding the pressure right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. Throw Jones. Now Jones is hit. He lost the football, and this is picked up by the Dolphins. And this is brought all the way back. A fumble recovery and taken to the house for a Miami touchdown. And what we just saw, very, very rare. We only had five of those in the first 50 Super Bowls.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and we just saw it happen again. Extraordinary.
The defense has been good, and they were good again there. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that pushes the lead up to 11. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Here's Tua. The left side completion to Jones. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. And that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
He'll find Jones again, complete. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 15-yard line. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And the Giants' drive will start from deep in their territory with a first and 10. The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. And Ingram hauls it in. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And offense. offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Looking to throw. Jones forced out to his left. Completes it to Evan Engram. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. So it's halftime here on Sports Grandest Stage in the Super Bowl. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And right now, their chances of hoisting that Lombardi trophy not looking too great, but perhaps that long halftime, maybe it did them a world of good.
But if there's ever a chance to regroup, it's in this game, right? Because you do have that long halftime, a chance to really assess things and maybe make some changes and true adjustments. They played great all year long. That was the worst first half of the season for them. They're hoping to put it behind them and come out punching here in the second half.
From the 27, Jones. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 46. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
A gain of 3, second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. He's got the first down here inside the 30, and he'll be taken down at the 26.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Jones running on first down, but finding it pretty tough going as he'll get forward for only about 3 there before he's taken down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now an open man, that's the tight end Gesicki. It's complete. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there.
And that's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up in excellent shape with a 1st and goal.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete. Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. Jones diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown.
And that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench because they accomplished exactly what they set out to do. Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves offensively. They helped their defense out as well.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is up to 18 now. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that? middle of the field, a breakaway. Touchdown, Giants.
I tell you, for a defender, that's got to be a scary sight, seeing a big man like this with a head of steam behind him as he makes that catch and then turns upfield.
Yeah, normally when you talk about tight ends, you immediately begin talking about them rumbling down the field. But to me, he was pretty well gliding downfield there. Very athletic for a big man, and he takes this one all the way to pay dirt.
Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Here's Jones again on second down. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And this defense going to bring out a couple extra DBs here on third and a yard. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there is no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. That's complete to his receiver, Pettis. Able to push his way through. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of six there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, he was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch. Maybe you move some motion. Maybe you put them on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open. Now it's second and nine. Going to the air, Tagovailoa out to his left. Looking for Pettis, but that's intercepted. Picked off by Xavier McKinney. And the Giants are going to take over here up near the 40.
Well, when he feels the pressure, naturally he likes going to his left, as most left-handed quarterbacks do. But this time he tries to let this go on the run, and it's going to wind up getting intercepted.
Now left side on the swing pass. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. 38-yard line, second and 11. A give to Barkley out of the gun. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw. Jones. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. this third quarter of play. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Giants with possession of the football but needing points as we start quarter number four. Jones now. Off play action. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Emmanuel Ogba able to get him down for a loss of 11. And it brings up fourth down. And the Giants send out their punter now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they have been the better of the two sides to this point with a two-score lead, fourth quarter of this Super Bowl, and the Lombardi Trophy within reach as they start this drive first and 10. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
Now, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. Tua gonna throw. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. A check down here to Jones. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. That'll give him eight that time, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Tagovailoa going for it on fourth down. It's complete to Fuller. And some space here. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. From the gun, it's Tua. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 13-yard line.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first. first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling, and this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Calling a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Flushed out right. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Sanders' kick is good, and that will get the lead up to 14.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. He'll get this complete to Kadarius Toney. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Throwing Jones. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 45-yard line. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. He'll buy some time right, and he'll just get rid of it. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
To throw on second and 10. Jones. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught inside the five. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now Jones, he's going to let it go again, and it's knocked away and incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter, maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Giants on third down, they've converted three out of five thus far. This will be third and forever. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. To throw is Jones. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Dolphins get the football in great field position. first down. It's Jones. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Here's second and nine.
They'll go again to Jones. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Tagovailoa going to try and throw on third down. Throw left side here, complete to the tight end, Gesicki. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. That is likely the final play of this game, and no better feeling, I would imagine, than taking a knee to wrap up the Super Bowl.
Culminates everything. The championship is theirs. And just think, the last play they had in practice before this game began was doing this, practicing taking a knee and winning a Super Bowl.
And they get to do just that. Lombardi Trophy has a home in South Florida. The Miami Dolphins are your Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.